Now I am joined now by our skin and beauty expert Jennifer Rock, who is here to answer all of your skin related questions. Now I am absolutely enthralled about skincare, and I had a Hydrafacial yesterday, as luck would have it. That's just coincidence, because I knew you were coming, because I've had terrible trouble over the last couple of months with kind of adult acne, and it's been driving me bananas over the Christmas period, of course. Well, it got worse, didn't it? Between the alcohol and the chocolate and all the So I went in yesterday, and I'm hoping it might actually boost and kickstart my skin for 2019. So
what look for it is that a lot of people tend to find that they get acne, traditionally associated congested blackhead skin with teenagers, but it's not the reality. Hormones change, our skin doesn't sway properly, we misuse products, a lot of things can affect why we would get breakouts at this age.
All of the above.
But Hydrafacial is really good. The thing is, right, I always just compare skincare to a dentist. So what you do at home is 90% of the battle, in my opinion, like brushing your teeth. You wouldn't go to the dentist and just have a good clean once a year and expect to have beautiful teeth. But it is important also to go and kind of have a treatment dermatological option as well. And a Hydrafacial is a good one to get.
Okay. So I did the right thing. And I put the money down and I did it, and I bought some products. I'm broke now, Jerry. But the thing is, it's important to look after your skin. And we've got a great question here, because when she was doing the facial with me yesterday, she said that I need to start wearing SPF, because I'm 40 now and I'm starting to get a few little spots in my arm. Which this lady has said here, why should SPF be worn all year round? And actually, that's a question I'd love to know.
The thing is, I think in Ireland we grow up thinking we don't have the sun, we don't have heat. And there's an element of truth that obviously we had a good summer last year, hopefully a good one this year. But the daylight, even these kind of synthetic lights, if you're sitting in front of a computer all the time, all of those lights have improved and have a negative impact on your skin. So it's important that we protect our skin. It is an organ, it deserves to be shielded and loved and TLC'd, and that's what an SPF is. And then there's the other side, people then debate about vitamin D. So I'm not saying to put SPF on to the point that you don't synthesize vitamin D, but just put it on, every single day just to protect your skin. It only lasts a couple of hours while it's on the skin, so just to give it that layer of protection effect.
And what number should we put on?
So I used to teach SPF classes which were 48 hours long, so it was 3-day courses, so I ain't going to do that, promise. But what I would say is that I'm a bigger fan of higher numbers, because we don't tend to put on as much as the company would want us to. So if you're putting a 50 on, unless you're putting on 2 centimeters squared, putting on 50. So yeah, higher number, more.
Let's go with the higher numbers. Now, toner with alcohol. This is question number two. Now, this lady says, I once heard a rumor that you should not use toner with alcohol in it after the age of 40. I'm 40. What are we doing? Is this true? Do we need to do this or not do it?
I don't really believe that skincare should change massively throughout the decades. I think that, like, you should eat broccoli at 40, a 20-year-old should broccoli at 20, at 90 you should broccoli. So there's kind of a key ingredient concept that SPF will always apply regardless of your age. So when this thicker lady asks about alcohol and lack thereof from 40 onwards, I wouldn't really worry about the age so much. I would wonder about the level of alcohol in any product. Because we know alcohol inside maybe isn't very good for us, and the exact same would apply to the outside. So be careful of the type of alcohol you're applying on your skin, because it can be quite dry. Now, there are some alcohol products, I'll put a list up on my own Facebook page later just to clarify. There's some alcohol products that are just there for preservatives, and there's some alcohol products that are there that are slowly trying to dry out your skin. So it's just being careful of what would acknowledge, unfortunately.
Jennifer, obviously somebody was talking to me about salicylic acid, am I getting that right?
Yeah.
And that I should be using that on my skin to help with the acne and obviously drying. It does dry it out though a little bit more, but it's more medicated. Would that be a way forward?
So salicylic acid is effectively, it's a beta hydroxy acid, which